All right.
Oh, there we go.
There we go.
There we go.
Okay, we were talking.
All right, we're going to back up there. Sorry about that, guys. Holy cow.
Don't
try this at home. Okay, we discussed how tall my hair has gotten.
Yeah.
We're no longer going to announce the days of the virus and how long we've been here. Just do it by the height of the hair.
That's what it is.
So,
But so what we were discussing is the big news, big news.
Big news.
Is that, so we've been telling you guys that Jim has been passing kidney stones. Well, he was still having problems and back pain and stuff, so finally we had a test done, and it's not a kidney stone. It's a kidney boulder he has in there. So we're trying to find some way to get it out of there.
Yeah.
We're going to pound that.
So we found out it was 11 millimeters, which when I used Google to try to figure it out, it looks like it's almost a half inch. That is a big sucker. We're thinking about using this broadcast to name it. All right.
So anyway, Jim's kidney boulder.
So we were discussing too that Sunny's laughing at me because I only do the front of my hair, just doing the front. We're on camera. She's just never done a lot of camera stuff.
She's
working all back here and everything, but I'm like, I don't care what
he goes like this with his hair.
Yeah, my thing is I don't care what people think when I'm leaving the room.
Right. Exactly.
I barely care when they think
about it. Okay, but here's the funny
thing. Oh, yeah.
This is pretty funny. So we called to set up his imaging point for his CT scan and everything. And the lady said, well, just to let you know, we have a special going on. And you can get MRIs for like $200 and you can get a CAT scan for $150.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm like, I didn't know imaging centers had specials. That was their special for the month.
Yeah.
She said business has been really slow, so they're running some specials. I don't know. That just seems like a really bizarre thing to me.
Yeah, so I think what I'm getting is I pay for the first kidney stone, and the second one is free.
I know, like, I didn't know there was going to be so many deals.
What a world we live in, though. Isn't that funny?
Things like that. So you can get a CAT scan. If you go to this imaging center, you can get a CAT scan at a special price. It was only $150. I don't know how much they usually
are. I don't know either, but we're on Obamacare and about half of that.
We're on no insurance.
Yeah, basically no insurance. On mine, she has better insurance than I have. The one that I have is when you drive into the hospital, they meet you in the parking lot. They give you a Band-Aid and an Advil, and they send you back home.
That's about it.
So we're on catastrophic.
Okay, but here's even the worst thing. We go to the imaging center. Did we remember the masks that Beth made us? No.
No.
No, we walk in, and I'm like...
They were in the washing machine. Yeah. Oh, and we got a new set of masks.
Somebody else did us a mask.
I forget who. Oh, shoot. We just got them today, and we just barely opened the box.
Right. So anyhow, I'm like, oh, my gosh, we're here without masks.
Michael Hogan is my son. Okay, there you are. There's the big bombshell for today. Mm-hmm. Michael Hogan, I have known him since just about birth. I think I met him. He was about 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or whatever. But Michael, I had the privilege of trying to corrupt him.
Dad is here.
He's from...
This is your sign language show.
That's pretty good. Michael's from Mobile, Alabama. I'm glad to hear you. Glad to see you there, Michael. So hope you enjoy the show. Remember, Michael, the more sarcastic you are, the better off the show is, and you get to win the potential of winning this dubious award of the squishy foam tooth, which you are... Oh, we've been leaving it in the sun. It's kind of faded.
Oh.
You get to possess this emotionally for 24 hours.
I think
hours,
that's actually pollen on the top of that or something.
Oh, that could be.
Yeah, I think
it could be.
So... you will get a new one.
Yeah.
Because they deserve a new one.
Yeah, it's only emotionally
possessive. But we do have some great awards to announce tonight for the pictures.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. We've got some good stuff going on.
We have the cutest and the funniest, but we have some special ones.
Yeah. Now what's going to be funny is when people watch this later, a lot of our people, and they'll be the first 2 minutes like, my sound isn't working.
I do that anyhow. You know, don't you? Like, it's always muted, and then I'm trying to figure out, and then half the video's played. And
there's something about when you watch videos, like on YouTube, or and you do it too, you'll be on Facebook, and you'll click on a video, and then you start scrolling down to look at other stuff. But you realize as soon as you click on it, you're laying there in bed, and the sound is like, it's like stadium sound.
Right.
I mean, you could have it on half volume, but you're laying in bed, there's nothing on, and you're both just working on your phones. It's like stadium sound.
He does that all the time.
It's like... Like you don't. Like you don't. Seriously.
He always has the sound on.
All right. Chris says it's 65 and sunny in Minnesota. He's doing burgers on the grill. Ooh, what did we do on the grill today? Oh, I did a quesadilla on the grill today.
He did do a quesadilla.
And you
did pork chops.
She did pork chops.
He cooked them for me, to be honest.
Now we have Herb Thurn is now watching.
Oh, Herb. Now that we're talking about hair.
We got Herb.
Herb sent in his picture.
Yeah.
And I love his picture.
Isn't
that adorable?
Trying to imitate me. It's just tragic when you're, what is he, 104?
That is Herb's.
I can't remember.
Actually, Herb, I think, see,
is
we got to like,
better?
Herb,
I
think, wears it well.
I'll try to match him there. Is that about right?
He actually looks a lot like Jim. I think you guys look like brothers.
I think I'm a little thicker, but he might be better looking there. He's got that goatee going on.
All right, remember, if you have Jim Peters hairdos, you gotta send them in.
We
like
giving,
those.
We're giving special awards tonight. We are shipping out superhero T-shirts to the winners.
To the winners.
To those of you that just get what we call dubious awards, you're just going to get a like honorable mention. We can ship you an empty bottle of water if you'd like, or one square of toilet paper.
Oh,
you have to specify
Chris
what
and
you
Linda,
like.
You're doing it's 65, and they're doing
burgers on the
burgers
grill.
On
I already
grill.
Said that. Were you
oh,
here for
I
that?
Oh, I didn't. Yes. I was looking for things.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay.
That's awesome.
Marines gave a bottle of water and 500 mg of ibuprofen. Oh, that was your that's
See?
Their medical. Thing.
Yeah.
Chef Charlie is watching.
Hi, Charlie. How are you doing?
We want to tell you again if you're, I posted on my Facebook page, Charlie, I hope you saw that. He was interviewed on the TED show, not the TED Talks, but this is the TED show. So if you go to my Facebook page, there's a fantastic interview with Ted or with Charlie about his amazing barbecue.
Yeah, I know. We talk
it's
about
called
it all
Getting
time.
Messy.
I know. We love it.
Do we have a sponsor tonight? Are we sponsored by a, no? We didn't put up a sponsor commercial, did we?
No,
for later
we don't have a
we don't have
one tonight. Which reminds me, did you enjoy our?
Oh yes,
I know we did the music video at the end, and I'll bet you anything, if you guys really watched it, the song was stuck in your head. Jesus is my friend.
Yeah, see, don't start.
Jesus it's is like, my friend.
Yeah,
we say to each other all the time, Jesus is my friend.
Yes,
but you have to kind of say it like that, like a singy songy.
Yeah. So Herb says I must have worked on my hair. He thinks I cheated today.
Oh no. Oh, no.
I have a secret to tell you. People have asked me lately what my hair care product is because you're not really going anywhere. So it's a guy thing. You know, I've been wearing the same pants for several days. Maybe, maybe not. I've got my daytime stretchy pants and my nighttime stretchy pants, which stretchy pants are deadly.
Right.
They're deadly, especially for boys. Not for girls because they're easy form fitting, but guys are baggy.
Okay,
so,
Chris, you said, are we blurry?
We're not
blurry. He said, you're blurry. I don't know if he's like being
he's
like...
he's kidding us.
He's very blurry. Like, no, I would get that.
The point is, of my story, is this is hand lotion. I put hand lotion in my hair. All right, Chris says
Did you really?
Yeah. Chris says we're blurry. We're going to check it here, Chris. All right.
I know. We're going to... Hopefully... On our screen, it's showing that it's fine. And now, there we go. It's still the same. All right. Weigh in.
Tell
us if we're blurry. Let us know.
Is that better?
The bad thing is, I think internet connection's not going to be...
Can you see my pores? That's the important part. Can you see my pores?
Do you want to see them?
That's... Yes. Oh, look at that beard.
He
that
said
is pretty
yes.
good looking. Okay. All right, great.
Oh,
thanks, guys.
TMI, Jim, on the pants. What are you wearing?
Hey. This is newscaster apparel.
Thank
Go
God.
Go in an expensive shirt. Who cares about the pants? That's from
wait,
Anchorman.
No,
you remember that.
Chris, are you saying we're blurry? I think you still say we're blurry.
No, Chris.
Are we?
Would you... Linda,
better,
clean his glasses.
It's better.
Adam Gould has joined us. We love Adam Gould. He's back. I don't know what happened to him, but he's back. Oh, Chris says it's better. So there, we're good with that.
All right.
So we were going with the MRI special. Some of the people just joined. So I have. I would ask for your prayers now. We might pray for me at the end. I don't know. But I have a 11-millimeter stone that, as I did my math on Google, it's almost a half inch. So it ain't going out. So we've got to figure out what we do next. So we go to the doctors tomorrow morning, a urologist.
I had to put it in context. So basically, a 4-millimeter, you can pass. A 5-millimeter, 20% chance. Anything above a 5, it's not going in.
Yeah, it's too many men on the field.
It's an 11.
Yeah.
It's an 11.
Yeah.
That's what I said earlier. That's a boulder. That's huge.
Cameron Rivers is joining us.
Big.
Cameron, we're discussing my kidney stone because you were late to the program. We got to bring you up to speed.
Right,
it's 11 millimeters.
People can just come on and not talk to
okay.
talk or anything.
Yeah. Pandora was late. She's finally here.
No, she was here earlier.
Was she?
Okay. Yeah, she was here.
And Patty Palamaki.
All right. So one of the things I showed you guys earlier is Jim, Sydney wants us to do TikToks with her because she's here and she can't do anything else and she's trying to entertain herself. So I think laughing at us is one of the ways she entertains herself. So anyway, I showed you this video, which is quite hilarious. It's Jim dancing and learning the moves of the TikTok. All right, so here they are.
Here we go.
This is Jim.
There's no
moves.
Audio. It's just us. We're narrating it through here.
Right.
But look at
the
these.
Next one.
These are rough, I will admit. But when we get to the finished video, these are like MJ videos, Michael Jackson videos.
Now, you don't understand is there's no volume, so you can't imagine.
Do it again.
Jim is actually saying, is this a 7-step?
No, I said, is this an 8-count or a 4-count? They were saying it's a 7-count. There is no 7-count in choreography, having been a professional choreographer for many minutes.
All right, so Anyhow, there you go. Have to
slide.
Show you.
It's the step.
I know.
All right. Now, here comes the finished product with audio. We'll be silent so you can take it
right.
all in.
You have to take this
yes.
in.
Yes. Got to take it all
Please
in.
Please watch his step.
Yes. Here we go.
I'm not doing very well myself, but Jim's the character you've got to keep an eye on. All right. Here we go.
I could get you satisfied.
Yeah,
and you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way we about to.
Yeah, right. Did you see that? You had to really watch his foot moves.
Those were good. Would you like to see it again? No. I think it deserves an encore.
Oh, we'll play it at the end.
We're going to build up the audience. Are we losing the audience?
I'm like, what even is that? Like,
I don't even know.
What kind of... And she put that up. I don't know if I would have done that. I thought that was pretty brave of her, I got to tell you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She was pretty proud of us.
Yeah, I thought that was... Yeah. Jim can count past four.
Yeah, Adam.
I think that was serious, a question.
Serious. Who said
James
that?
James Rister did.
Oh, Jim, come on. Of course I can count past four. I can get to six or
Dad
seven.
Dad said when he was young he had a flat top with ducktails. Now bald top with ducktails, maybe ponytails. I did see, Dad, you have a little tuft there growing
he
now.
He does.
You
got
can't
a little
get your hair
poofy
cut.
Thing going on up there.
Yeah.
See, look at that. That's
there
pretty
go.
Good, guys. All right, appreciate that. Picking up some more people here.
All right, one of our questions tonight is going to be,
yeah.
If you could do a TED Talk, what
yeah.
would your TED Talk be about?
Yeah.
So, or what if Jim were to give a TED Talk, what do you think Jim's TED Talk would be about?
Okay, I like that one. Go ahead and weigh in on that. But tomorrow we're going to ask you, what do you think your TED Talk would be about?
Right.
Just for fun, because we'd yeah. like to know what your friends would think you would be doing. Or you could ask your wife or your significant other or your ex, whatever. But we'll figure that out. Aaron Free has now joined us.
Dude, people are saying, I can't see it again. I tore my eyes out.
Who said that? Adam
and
Gould.
And Gwendolyn said, I can't unsee that now.
Adam is just mean. He
yeah.
used to be one of my best friends. Not no more.
There's actually, we did another video with her. These TikToks are driving me crazy. She's here for two more weeks, and then she leaves us.
Dear Jesus,
yeah.
pray
She'll
for all
She'll probably be
us.
With
pray
us on Friday,
us.
But...
It's like, have you seen What About Bob? It's like, What About Bob? Remember when Richard Dreyfuss finally throws him out of the house? And
yeah.
then, and their family's all hurt that you threw Bob out. And he goes, he's not
gone. He's not gone.
And he goes over and opens the door. He's still here.
It's so
That's
true.
What it feels like with my daughter. I'm telling you, she'll never leave.
She loves being
We've got to stop feeding her so much. It's just, you know, if you stop feeding them.
Well, I've had to cook. I don't like cooking.
No. What is Aaron saying?
Bus supposed to be.
Well, that's one of my old lines with him.
That's one of Jim's lines.
What's a TED Talk? Herb Thurn wants to know what the TED Talk is. Can somebody just put it on
I
this
know.
Thing here?
That's a hard
TED Talks are these entrepreneurs and business leaders and civic leaders. And
But you're supposed to talk on whatever you're an expert in.
Yeah, you got 25 minutes
20
about.
Minutes.
Yeah, 20
it can't
minutes.
Be over 20
That's
minutes.
Right.
And you do this TED Talk and people, and there's like a
Yeah, so what would be the
now.
One theme of your life that you'd like to put on a TED Talk? All right?
Yes.
There you go. So
like
see
for
what
Herb,
you got
you
for
could
that.
Be, how do you deal with Jim?
Oh, Herb's could be how to fix anything in 30 minutes or less.
He could do that. Herb, you got he's
if,
got serious
If you're looking behind skills. Us, the light's up there, that's Herb. Let's see, what else? Oh, the mirror hanging over here, that's Herb. I don't know what else. You can't see much else, but Herb has done tons on the Warrior House here.
I got to tell you, nobody commented about my video.
Hey, if you're a Warrior watching, we want to remind them, you're looking at the front door of the Warrior House.
Right.
Our house is across the pool. And this is the house that we have remodeled and everything. It had lots of volunteers and where
yeah.
we were able to house guys who come down here to go to the parks, or at least
right.
what were the parks.
Right,
Now
exactly.
you just go to the beaches.
I know, they're talking about really extending Disney.
Contact us privately offline or off the string here and
right.
we would be happy to put some dates down to get you here if you're a veteran
okay,
or military.
Okay, well, so speaking of vets, so one of the things that they love, and it's something we put in all of our survival kits for the guys, is a book it's from Chuck Norris. And they love Chuck Norris. And do you want to explain Chuck Norris?
Chuck Norris is, how do you explain Chuck Norris? Jeez, old Pete.
I'll find that and you explain
okay.
Chuck.
Chuck Norris is the man who built America single-handedly. Chuck Norris is, it's an urban legend around, he is an actual real person, Walker, Texas Ranger.
He's like in his 80s, I
yeah,
think
Yeah, I think we looked him up, he's 80. But he got this thing got started in colleges 15 years ago or whatever, and it's still popular, but about Chuck Norris Book of Facts is what it is. So if you can't see it, we give this out to wounded guys all the time. We love this book. It is a huge hit with military guys. So we hand it out, but it's all these amazing
stats.
But
he's like a black belt, but he's like in the eighth
level. Jiu-jitsu or something, I don't know, but
he's
one
amazing.
Of the grand masters or
right.
something. I don't know all that stuff.
He was
stuff
in a lot of movies. He had a Texas Ranger, right?
Or Walker, Texas Ranger. Yeah. Already said that, but
sorry.
That's okay.
Okay, but here, what's so great about him
is
that he's supposed to be really tough. So, like, this is one of the...
This is how we deal with the coronavirus. It's just Chuck.
Chuck can drink the coronavirus. All right. So, but like, here's some of the sayings that they have for Chuck.
Yeah, these are great.
He can the pillow under his gun.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was it.
Right. That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the seventh day, God rested and Chuck Norris took over.
Okay, so now as we've got these up here, if you've got a great one, go ahead and give us one. But,
right, if you know any Chuck Norris, you've got to share them with us because we love Chuck Norris.
We love Chuck Norris. Chuck Norris can gargle peanut butter and blow bubbles with beef jerky. That's one of my faves.
Or how about this one? Chuck Norris makes onions cry.
See? That's good stuff right there.
That's some good. That's good.
Chuck Norris will never have a heart attack. His heart isn't foolish enough to attack him.
When Chuck Norris exercises, the machine gets stronger.
The other one I saw, we've told a lot to the guys, is Chuck Norris, when he does push-ups, he pushes the earth away. It's good stuff.
I know. You know what? Maybe it's our kind of sense of humor.
Yeah.
I know. We love them.
So if you've got Jay's, your relative Jay is watching. So if you've got Chuck Norris one, you can give us one.
Right.
If you got something there. That'd be great.
All right. So you know that we're going to give out the award tonight for the cutest and the funniest.
And we know the audience is building.
I know. It's just...
It's building. Yeah. It's,
right.
up to single digits.
Wednesdays are always bad days.
Yeah. But we're still here. We like it.
All right. So anyhow, you ready? Can we start with our pictures?
Chris's theme would be customer service. Linda says that's awesome.
You
love Chuck
do
Norris, Pandora.
On dancing, on disco dancing.
Rachel Doring has joined us now, so we can...
Oh, see.
Rachel's...
She didn't give us a picture of her as a kid.
No, what's up with that, Rachel? You were one of the cutest kids I'd ever met. I don't know what happened to you as you got older.
Downhill
severely.
She's adorable.
Cut her own hair the other day with a weed whacker. I don't know what the heck happened.
Well, I did my bangs.
Ugh, Rachel. It's terrible. You got to come down and help her on her bangs.
I know,
it's
I always cut my bangs. I can't hang them in my eyes.
I don't know how Rachel hasn't killed somebody in her house. She's got like 4 or 7
kids.
It does
seem like a lot of kids.
And
in
your
that
brother...
House.
And, like, a husband. I mean, it's, like, too many people in this house.
He was out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere. He just showed up. Chad's awesome. I have not had the privilege of meeting him.
I do think it's hard for these extroverts. Like, I can be a mix. Introvert, extrovert. But, like, he's going crazy.
Now, Herb says his TED Talk would be Jack of All Trades and Master of None. That would be his TED Talk.
No, he's a master of a lot. Yeah.
He's a master of a lot. He can eat,
him
like,
and my dad,
pieces.
Yeah. That's, like... I don't have those skills.
Herb will always be number one in her book for a bunch of different reasons, but the recent one most is what? What did he bring you to?
Oh, yeah. See, he was the one that brought me Beef on Weck, which I talked about the other day.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love Beef on Weck.
Yep.
Buffalo cuisine right there.
Okay, Chuck Norris actually had a part in the movie Star Wars. He was the Force. James, that's good.
James might have
line of the day. Remember, we're all going for the dubious award of line of the day
to
be given that. And the person from...
I know. And if Pam Crawford comes on here, we did her wrong because she actually should have gotten line of the day the other
Pam
day, too.
Yeah, Pam should have
got it.
Yep.
Because
she
said, I've been on here 2 minutes and Jim's touched his face 9 times. Because Jim likes
to touch. So we got to write down James with his Chuck Norris quote so we don't forget it because my ADHD is about to kick in.
We got to remember you. You're worthy of the award.
That's it.
Right.
All right.
So let's go to the... I think we should show the...
Go for it.
The pictures.
Yeah, go for it.
All right. So we made up our own award. So it's not just the two awards.
Yes.
It's two more.
We're going to make you stick around for the actual presentation.
You
got to
wait
awards.
A minute.
Yeah.
Until we give these
one of the recipients
out.
Is not here yet is part of the problem.
All right. Well, here we go.
You have to be present to win.
So this is Tracy.
Yeah.
And
Tracy,
we gave her the most skin award.
The most skin award.
Yes.
There's a lot of skin.
That's
right
a
there,
lot
people.
Of skin.
We're going to take that off because Facebook is probably pulling our site down right now as we speak. I'm thinking. All right, who
we
you
thought
got?
That was cute.
That's very cute.
I know. Okay.
Yep. She had the courage to send it in.
No.
You know.
This one is actually...
I don't think Lydell's on yet.
Yeah, and he actually, he was the one, he had the, he was the one that sang in North Dakota.
Oh, yeah, the North... Remember
yeah,
when we were
sponsored... Yeah, he gave us our North Dakota commercial.
Yes, we were sponsored by North Dakota.
Yeah.
So we don't have a sponsor today. If you'd like to be a sponsor and you can sing a jingle, if you send it to me on Facebook or message me, text me, we will consider being sponsored by your commercial, that is. But it has to be an audio or a video clip.
Right.
You can have that.
Fun if possible.
Yeah, there you go. That's right.
All right. And then the next... Here, maybe I should do this. The Most Teeth Award.
Yeah.
And that one went to...
I don't think she's online.
I don't think she is either.
Lisa
I think
Cloud.
Everybody's probably out having fun. The weather's probably nice.
If you look close enough, you can actually see her molars. I mean, the girl smiles. It's like it goes all the way back to her ear. It's like, what was that? The mask, right?
I love
right?
that smile.
The mask. He was with James, mask. Jim oh, Carrey yeah. would smile like that. Yeah.
All right. Chris said, no street named Chuck Norris because you don't cross Chuck Norris.
Oh.
That's pretty good.
That
Did
might
he
make
be, that one up?
He might be line
you
of the day.
You guys are really good.
Okay. We got to put down Chris.
Yeah. I can't. You know what? I can't make that up. I'm not that creative. Jim's my creative one.
All right. Here we go.
Okay. Oh, and I don't think Kim's on either, and she's usually on.
All right, so we're doing...
The Happiest Baby Award.
Oh, here's the Happiest Baby Award from all the entries that
Look
we had.
Look at her.
She's so happy.
I just am like, that's like...
What is up with that?
Chuck Norris counted to infinity 3 times.
We're doing Chuck Norris quotes. So if any of you've got a Chuck Norris quote, you could win Line of the Day and receive the dubious award that you only get to possess emotionally for 24 hours till the next broadcast. We ain't shipping it to you.
Right.
It's probably got Corona all over it.
Yeah,
so
Jim,
there you go. We don't give them
up. Yeah. And I don't think Don's on here. Okay, this is my dad. Well, he's our friend, too.
Hold it. Is Rachel going for Line of the Day?
Why
was that it? She said, well, she's the one that said Count to Infinity 3 times.
I know.
Do we consider that a Line of the Day?
I love the Rachel? Chuck Norris.
All right, so Rachel, we're going to put you down for potential Line of the Day, but we're not giving it to you if you're not here at the end, Rachel.
What's so funny is that Chuck Norris actually says, because I don't even know how this started. Like he's like, it's out of nowhere. He's like, they make me into this person that I'm definitely not, but I think it's adorable. Okay, so... The next one is the Studley Award.
Ooh.
And Don Bush got it because look at how
Look
cute.
At this dude.
Isn't
we love
that
Don.
Awesome?
Now, Don is a Chief Master Sergeant in the Air Force. 31 years, I believe.
What
Amazing
a
guy.
Is.
Highest rank you can go in the Air Force in enlisted.
Right.
And he had it for several years and stayed in. He's just an incredible guy. He's gone to the hospital with us to work with combat injured troops. He's just an amazing guy.
Yeah,
we just love
amazing.
Him. Him and his wife, Peg.
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 Don and Peg.
We love Miss Peg.
We love them.
Yeah,
and
we
then
do.
I don't think Dee's on either. I'm going to just...
Honey, we do have one other rookie that's watching tonight that we should pay a little attention to. It's Heather Martinez.
Oh, Heather.
Heather did not submit any baby pictures.
No.
There were none taken.
I was surprised, actually, you didn't submit one for her.
Oh, I could have, actually. I could pull one up on my phone and put it up just because Heather's watching and I love to embarrass
her. Okay, so right now, this is Dee. This is our good friend Dee.
Oh, yes.
I love this picture. So that is her grandmother and they're in Jamaica. That's where she's from. And that's her little cousin, she said. But isn't she so cute? Dee rocks. Like, she's had a gazillion jobs and she's a vet and was Army. She's jumped out of airplanes. She's incredible.
Yeah, she's a rock star.
Okay, and so this is our Reverend. We got to give this award to our Reverend David Wells.
Oh,
this
yeah.
This one's so cute.
Oh, yeah.
He is so fun, but he's so stinking serious.
There
so he
is.
He got the most serious award.
He's now the head of the Pentecostal Assemblies of Canada, so we're probably, he's going to have to impeach us or something. I don't know what you do up there for that, but
you
can tell he's going to be somebody very serious. I've known Dave since 88. We've had more laughs, but I'm telling you, that is all Dave right there.
I mean, he's a kid, and look how serious he is.
He's just ready to take over the world.
Yeah,
maybe.
Like, you're like,
I couldn't sit
present.
Still that long. All of my pictures are videos, because I never sat still that long.
And, of course, I had to, you guys haven't seen this one. This one's to our disco skater.
Oh, yeah.
Of the group.
Yeah, here we go.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Look at this picture.
This is it. Yeah. This
that is awesome.
We maybe should try to get some captions for that picture. I'm just thinking, FBI wanted list. I'm thinking, is this picture something you see in a post office,
gosh,
but in black and white version?
Look how cute you are.
Them glasses are like magnifiers. It's like Mr. Magoo glasses, Chris. I'm telling you.
I like those.
Pandora gave us a Chuck Norris. She says, when the boogeyman goes to sleep, he checks his closet.
Wait.
He checks his closet for Chuck.
Right, exactly. Yeah, right.
Susan Wells just joined us.
Oh,
now, Susan, we're
going to
put the picture back up again because I don't know if she saw
it. Susan just came on. That's her. I think she probably really submitted the picture. It's her husband.
Yeah, we cut you out, Sue.
David Wells.
Yeah, we cut you out, Sue, because the ratings dropped severely when we did a test market on it. All right, so.
Look how cute. He's so adorable, but I love how serious he is.
My favorite son, Jay the Loser, he's on watching right now, Jay Wetzel. Love Jay. So there you go.
All right, and then, so we did Chris.
Rachel just said, Susan, did you see what Rachel just said about David Wells? Rachel Doring, who lives up in Michigan, she just says, David Wells is Chuck Norris. That's pretty good, Rachel. We might have to, Rachel, you're up for two dubious awards tonight.
David Wells was the one, he helped us with Invictus up in Toronto when we were there. And oh my word, he rocked it. He was over the chaplaincy and he was amazing.
Oh, Jimmy Bratcher is now on, just said something about David Wells.
Oh yeah, Jimmy stayed with Susan and David.
Yeah, they had to completely bring a hazmat team in to fix it all up after he
left. I knew something was coming. I knew the minute I said it, we were in trouble. Okay, so we got a photobomb award.
Oh, yeah.
And I think Jim explained
this is this is our buddy Chester from, he was a roadie of ours when our band toured Sweden and Finland and Northern Russia up in Siberia and Murmansk. Man, that was a great tour. But Chester played on the hockey team.
Right.
So he sends me this picture from his childhood, but the story is better than the picture. So that's Chester in the front right there. His real name's Christer, but we call him Chester. In the back, the guy actually skiing by is a professional, like one of the top skiers in Sweden at the time. And Chester photobombed it. It's a buddy of his taking the picture. And Chester jumps in front of the camera. And back in those days, you didn't know if it happened or not. So he completely ruined the kid's picture of this world-famous athlete. And there he is photobombing it.
See, this is what happens when you can... what'd you say?
You got to just move over a little.
Oh, that's okay.
They want to see your face.
They don't need to see
you. Yeah, that's it.
That's what happened back in the old days, which I talked about on Monday, is remember when we only had like 12, 24, and 36 pictures? And then you never knew, like, were they turning out? How are they going to look? Were they all going to have red eye?
All right.
Would they all be awful?
Yeah, Pandora submitted a line about Chuck Norris, but I think Pandora's been drinking. Pandora says, Chuck Norris can kill two stones with one bird. I don't know if is that written the right way. Pandora is supposed to be can kill two birds with one stone.
One
I don't
stone.
Know. I don't know. Jimmy Bratcher says that's because you're a big sissy.
Okay, you know Susan was saying the other day that we never cook. See, Jimmy cooks on his Facebook Live. So
yeah, no.
I think that was like challenge.
We are going to do an episode. Yeah, Susan says she watches your show because it smells better. Your show smells better.
Right.
That's what Susan says. So we are going to announce a couple of teasers here. We are going to have a cooking episode, and I promise you, it's going to blow Jimmy Bratcher's up.
Epic.
So we won't even announce Jimmy Bratcher's. Actually, he's been pulled off the air by Facebook, so don't even try to watch his program. He competes with us because his program is so lame. He's trying to steal our audience is what he's trying to do.
I love these. Are you guys looking these up? You guys must be looking.
Okay, Pandora's trying to redeem herself. Outer space exists because it's afraid to be on the same planet with Chuck Norris.
See, good like, stuff, aren't Pandora. These great? We love Chuck Norris.
Oh, Jim Brister says, Def once had a near Chuck Norris experience.
Oh my word, gosh. That's really
Don cute. Bush is watching.
You better
put the picture back up.
All
Don's
right, so
here.
Don's here. We're going to put it back up.
Don, we gave you an award tonight, Don, and we gave you the Stud Award.
The Studley
Award is what it is.
There you
and
are.
There you are, Don. We put you up on that because that's the man right there. Chief Master Sergeant right there.
Okay, Susan just said he cooks and sings.
Oh, Jimmy sings. Yeah, but it's old man singing. You don't want it. It's brutal.
Right. I hear you.
Notice the lower viewer count because of no Sydney. Chris just said,
send
it! No, not gonna happen.
I know. She's working on a paper. Actually, I was helping her with that paper right before we came on.
Yeah. It's brutal.
It's not fun. The research paper thing, no thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not my thing. Not my thing.
All right.
So did everybody answer about what's your TED Talk?
Yeah. What is your TED Talk going to be, people?
What would your TED Talk be?
Me?
Right.
I was not prepared for this. This is called dead air. Talk amongst yourselves.
What? How to be a comedian?
I don't know. Yep. How to marry two beautiful women at different times.
Okay.
That sounded terrible at first.
I know. I didn't know where you were going with that.
Yeah.
It's better than your dancing. Peg is floored. Oh, that you got Studley. That picture's awesome.
Yeah.
I bet Peg likes that picture.
Oh, yeah.
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 I think you should put it up on your wall.
Yeah, she'll be on her phone.
She'll be in your refrigerator.
Yeah, there you go.
There you
go. It's a fridge pick.
Right.
Oh, Jimmy says his broadcast is better than my dancing. Yeah, I don't think so.
All right, so Jimmy, who's here, Jim picked him. He came to visit us, him and his wife, Sherry, who we adore. And we picked him up at the airport. And Jimmy Bratcher's not a big fan of Kenny G. Well, you know what he did? Yeah, he actually took his shirt off as he's picking Jimmy up at the airport. And was playing Kenny G.
Full tilt. I'd been working out, too, so I looked better than I look now.
I had done two
or three push-ups on the way to the airport.
Sometimes I'm not prepared for these Jimmy Bratcher moments.
Jimmy Bratcher just said Jim would his TED Talk would be How to Love Kenny G. I kind of like that.
Oh, my word. I don't know what mine
Lisa
would be.
Lisa thinks that hers would be the art of a colorful vocabulary.
You know what? You would be so good at
Lisa,
that.
Lisa, you got an award tonight, but you were late, so we're not going to review it. You got to go watch from the beginning.
No.
And the first 2 minutes of our broadcast tonight, if you go back and watch it, please share our broadcast if you would. That would really help us.
Yeah,
but
the first few minutes.
No, the first few minutes we dedicated to the hearing impaired.
There you go, Lisa.
Yeah.
There you are.
Oh, man.
It was such a cute smile. Look at her.
It's like the smile from the mask. You can see her molars. I mean, it's all the way back there.
I love that, Lisa. I love how happy you look in that picture.
Jimmy says since we picked him up at the airport, he's been in counseling ever since.
It's like a PTS moment.
It is.
I get it.
No D.
I have those.
Yeah, no D.
I have those kind of moments all the time.
Yeah.
Chris Soderlund would understand. He's experienced it. All right, what are you reading?
Some of James.
There must be another one.
Jim is looking up Chuck Norris. That's right. O'Neill's TED Talk would be how to fix anything with duct tape.
That really applies to my
Linda Putz, you're late.
I love him, but he knows how to use duct tape. He's got some serious skills with duct tape.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't have that.
Let's see. Susan Wells says, just sent you a 30-year-old picture when you were talented like Jimmy. I just love him. All right, Susan has sent me a picture. I got to look up on my phone. So go ahead, talk to the people.
Talk amongst ourselves.
Talk amongst yourselves.
I don't know what I would do as my TED Talk. All right, keep them coming. I want to hear what everybody... Oh, Jim was off his meds. Sadly, there was no meds involved. You would think. You know, it's so funny because he always is like embarrassing me, and yet I keep putting myself
look
in these situations.
Look at this. I'm rocking it, honey. Susan took that. Susan, that's a nice picture. I got to keep that one. Look at this, people. Look at that. That's me. That's
me.
Playing a bass guitar solo out there for the audience. I was going to stage dive, but they all ran away.
That was the pre-white hair days.
Yeah. That was when I was
still
dying.
Still big hair.
That's done. Yeah, still a big hair.
Right.
That was actually many of the roadies we had named in Herman Munster. Thank you, Susan P. Wells. That was awesome. Perfect, perfect.
Well, are we ready for awards?
Oh, I think we should probably go to awards. Yep.
All right. We're going to go down. And two, the ones that you guys all voted on, which, you know, was the cutest and the funniest.
Okay.
We had no say in. Neither of us voted.
So are we going to review? Or are you going to run the whole tape again? Or are we just going to the winners?
We're just going to the winners.
Oh, I thought she should show all of them to see the participants. Yes, we had hundreds of incoming. Oh, if you don't have it, we could just
talk
about it.
Well, I can find it. You just... Oh, wait a minute.
We had hundreds of people send in their pictures, and we picked what we felt were about the 35 or 38 best.
Yeah.
And then from that, we whittled it down, and then our research team put it up on the web, and we did some... Got some awards out.
All right.
Of it,
well, Sydney actually, she did. She tallied them.
Yes, she
so
did.
So we
the
weren't
tally.
Even involved in the tallying.
Yeah, Sneed, Sneed, and Sneed tallied them. All right. So.
All right. This might take me a minute.
Oh, that's fine. So we're just working at it here. The other question we're going to go to tonight, when you all get, Lisa says your TED Talk, honey, should be how to deal with a very tall man child, and with grace. How to deal with a very tall man child with grace. I like it.
Okay, but you may not admit, you missed it probably, that we found out he has a kidney stone, but it's not just a kidney stone.
Yeah.
It's a boulder.
Yeah.
So he does everything large.
Susan,
everything.
Susan's from Canada, so she can do the conversion for us. So Susan, the stone is 11 millimeters.
1.1 centimeters.
Yeah, so 11 millimeters.
Right.
So tell me how much that is in finches.
It's a lot.
Yeah,
just
so figure that out for me, Susan P. And Jimmy Bratcher, if you want to try to do that math, you can, but you're going to have a seizure.
No.
And Chris, don't even bother.
I had to use the internet.
Chris is our accounting firm that we use for all of our awards. Aaron Free has just said something. The tears of Chuck Norris can heal coronavirus. Too bad Chuck Norris has never cried. Oh, that's good stuff. That's good stuff, but we've seen it before, Free. You got to do better than that if you're going for the line of the day.
All right.
Remember, you win line of the day, people, with the dubious award. We've given out... almost 18 of these now, and the stock is running low, the emotional stock. So did you find it? No?
No, I
Oh, okay, you're fine.
I
you're
know.
Good. All right, so we're going direct to the winners, ladies and gentlemen, of the beauty contest.
Right.
We have two awards that are the major awards. Are we doing those first or last? We'll do those last. The cutest and the funniest.
We have the cutest and the funniest.
That's right. We got the cutest and the funniest. So which one are you doing first?
Okay, I think we should do the cutest.
Oh, the cutest. Here we go.
The cutest award
goes to, drum roll.
Zach Somm.
Zach Somm. Put it up.
All right. And hang on one second.
There it is.
There
Zach
we go.
Somm. Whoop, maybe
it's
not.
It's
not working. Attention, ladies and gentlemen. I could draw a picture right here. I'll draw a little
picture.
There
it is.
Oh, there we go.
You know what we needed to put up is a picture of what he looks like now.
Oh, I'll pull it up on my phone and hold it up in the rinky-dink format that we do.
Tell
him who he is.
He just graduated from West Point. And if you guys remember, if you follow Jim or I on Facebook, we had visited his last home game up at West Point to watch him play football. And, oh my word, it was freezing, but it was definitely worth it. But he rocked it.
This is my daughter's favorite picture of Zach. This is him in his uniform, ready to go play after the game.
Hang on. I got to pull this out.
Oh, yeah, pull that off.
There you go.
There we go. That's Zach after a game and just signing autographs for a couple of little fans. But Zach played for West Point. Let's see, where else is he? Right. This is another favorite picture of us, of Zach. Made some sort of a play.
Right.
And so he played for the Military Academy at West Point, which is where all the Army officers are trained. Big
so
boy,
to see
6'4".
Him, yeah, to see this picture is just so cute. Look how cute he is.
He's a great kid. So we are very happy to present him with the Superhero T-Shirt Award.
Right, exactly.
He will get to pick between Spider-Man and, well, Star Wars.
He's received several of our shirts in the past. Yeah, we've taken him up to West Point. And
yep, he can pick between Spider-Man and Venom, and we have Black Panther right now.
He actually came down here, and he did an event with us, and he spoke to some of the people that were at the house.
Okay, so Susan P. Wells has also given us a very vital statistic we need right now from Canada, because she's all metric. Everything in her life is metric. She even walks metrically. Susan has she has done the conversion on my kidney stone. We're going to get a picture of it. And when I do get it out, we're going to display it in a hermetically sealed jar, I believe is what we're doing.
Right.
But anyway, it is 0.423 inches.
There you go.
I would call it a half inch.
Again,
that's just me.
I just want to put it in perspective. Is that a passable, the largest passable one is
basically... Pause for a second. As she describes this man, cross your legs.
I know.
Because it's going to be painful to hear
this. A 4 millimeter is passable. 5 is really not really passable. And his is 11 millimeters.
So my GP on the phone today didn't even get on the phone. He just had his admin call me and say,
You
got to go get somebody.
You got to get that out of there.
Yeah, that's not coming out.
He's like, however you can get it out, get it out.
Yeah,
it's
that's
blocking
it.
Things.
So I've called. There's a guy going to meet me behind Walmart tomorrow. We're going to see if we can take it out with a hammer. I don't know.
I was willing to pound it out.
Oh,
myself.
Lord.
I was willing.
That's pretty good stuff. All right. So,
okay.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yes. So now we have the funniest award.
The grand prize.
Right. Which is, this is actually pretty fitting.
This one, they were very close in the voting.
Oh,
actually,
was it?
Yeah,
you
it was.
Part of, you
actually, Zach's got a little bit higher. He was just under 1,000 on the votes. And then this one came in about 874, something in
all
there.
All right. So here we go. The funniest award goes
funniest
to.
Funniest picture award.
Bob Atwood. And here's the picture.
Here it is. There he is. This is the week he got diagnosed with being autistic. It's a joke, people. It's a joke.
I know. He's going to be
a joke. It's a joke.
Look at how cute he is. So many of these pictures are so cute.
That's right.
That's
Pandora
adorable.
Says of my kidney stone, some people grow them big.
He grows everything big.
Oh,
everything's
Lord.
Big.
Yeah, Lord.
Big hands.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a lot going on.
He
so there you
big.
Go. Those are the awards that you have been waiting for 2 days.
I know. Yeah. Bob is worthy.
He is.
He's definitely worthy of that award.
You know, we were talking about... this one, is that better?
Yeah, that's like, I don't, it's something. There you go. Big hair.
That's it.
He's got big hair.
So we were talking about, are you halfway through this thing? Are you a third of the way through this thing? We don't know where we are in the process. I tell you, we watched about 10 minutes of news this morning. We both put our foot through the TV.
Oh,
we're just
word.
Done.
We're so done.
We're
I know
now,
you guys are
now
too.
We're starting to divide. You know how that, we work with combat injured troops, and it's always at the end of the wars, things get really out of control because you get both sides in the House and Senate and the Republicans and the Democrats and the conservatives and liberals, they all start arguing over the whole thing and it's like, dear Jesus. See, but you know what? We just believe this, that something really good is about to happen.
Right.
It's like we said earlier, it's the first time in my lifetime in 64 years of being on the planet where the whole world is concentrating on one thing that does not divide us.
Right.
And we're all praying for a solution. We're all praying for healing. We're praying for protection. That's got some really positive energy going on. And so we really believe what comes out of this could really be amazing stuff. We really
right.
think there's going to be some people who are defined by this moment. We think there's some families that are really going to be defined by this moment.
Right.
Your family is stronger or you've learned how not to kill each other.
Well, we talked about the other day. Like, we've gone on walks and I cannot believe the families that I've never seen before and they're all out together and they're doing activities because nobody has anywhere to go. And I know you guys all know this, but...
Yeah.
Oh, I love seeing it because that's how we grew up. I grew up that, man, if I heard my dad whistle for me, I had to come home. But we didn't come home. I didn't want to come home. We were out playing and riding our bikes. You don't see that anymore.
Yeah, it's a lot more togetherness. And I know we laugh about that and it's too much togetherness and all that kind of stuff.
Right.
But in our life, I mean, I haven't spent that much time with Sydney. I mean, she was coming you know, for a few days here and there, but right. she was mostly in college from, you know, out of last year of high school, but well, she spent time with her dad.
You just said the other day, I mean, this is the most time we'll ever probably get to spend with her
yeah.
like this. I think Jim's hoping, like, she doesn't come back and live on our couch.
No, she's pretty easy, but I mean, it is strenuous. I don't know how people do it, like Rachel with 26 children.
I know.
What she got
and you guys are having to teach
I think
to
she
do
just
everything else.
Adopted an abandoned koala bear. I mean, Rachel's got everything in that house. So
Pandora says we are through. And to think we still have more days to go, and you know, it's a lot for everybody. I totally get it. We're there. We're with you guys.
Oh, Lisa's he looks like Eddie Munster. That is very
Chuck Norris can strangle you with a cordless phone.
I like that.
I hope everybody's reading
I've
these.
Stolen this line.
These
I think
so
I originally
awesome.
Got it from Chuck, but I've used it with a lot of people, and I've introduced them. I said they can kill you with a post-it.
When you introduce Chuck.
No. I stole it from Chuck, but when I introduce people, I use the line from Chuck.
Oh, that's cute. That's a cute idea.
He can kill you with a post-it. And just referring to anybody.
Right.
It's a great line.
Right.
So we're doing Chuck Norris
stuff.
He's
got some serious math skills.
Yeah. We're going to ask our question, I think, for tomorrow is going to be, and you can start talking about it tonight if you want, but what cartoon do you still enjoy? What's your go-to cartoon? What did you like as a kid? What do you go to? What we've been watching lately is very weird. We bought YouTube TV.
Right.
We're cable cutters. We don't have cable. We got Disney Plus, and we got some of those Netflix and stuff, and Amazon, of course. But we just got YouTube TV, and it has Hogan's Heroes. She was kind of rolling her eyes at it, but now she's been looking the characters up, and she's all into it now.
I know. We watched all the old shows. Andy Griffin, he even had this morning, I almost actually took a picture of it for you guys.
Oh, yeah.
He was watching The Bionic Woman. Now, see, some of you,
Lindsay Wagner,
Rachel are like, what is that? But it's, it was an old show.
I started watching Charlie's Angels. That was on. It was on Cozy TV, but it was the new cast. You know, I mean,
And actually, Chris, we talked about you because one of the episodes, they were.
Oh, yeah.
It was about a skating rink, and there was some sketchy stuff going on.
There was a murder at the skating rink. And Charlie's Angels.
It was really
Angels.
Cute, but the outfits they had on at the skating rink were really cute. Yeah. The one had suspenders on. I had those suspenders.
They're still lighting us up on Chuck Norris.
Well, I love Chuck Norris Ains.
Chris says, as a child, Chuck Norris only had dreams because the nightmares were scared. Linda says, I'm ready for the loony bin. I need my hair done and still have no place to go. I have no life. It's my fault.
I totally get it.
Pandora comes back in with Chuck Norris used to beat up his shadow because it was following too close. It now stands 15 feet behind him.
Who said that one?
Pandora.
That's cute.
Chad, your brother-in-law Dale says, Chuck Norris was exposed to the coronavirus. The virus had to be quarantined for 2 weeks. It's popping now. Karen Lynn just joined us. Chris says, go back and read my Chuck Norris joke.
Oh, Rachel.
Chris, no. We can't go back. We only go forward. This is
always
corona.
Always forward, buddy.
There's no reverse.
Rachel, I know. We get so behind. Rachel said, we should watch the movie Onward. Okay.
It's called Onward?
Yes. And Sydney actually suggested. I kind of thought it looked a little silly. But if you suggest it, we will give it a try.
Yeah, but she's got a brother that's about 7 years
old.
Oh,
he's a disco dancer. Why do we keep thinking you're a disco skater?
He was a skater.
He says he's not a skater. He was a disco dancer.
You'll always be a skater to me, Chris.
Okay, we'll take that off. You won the Disco Dancer Award. I got to tell you, you got to send us some moves. We will put them up for everybody to enjoy.
Well, you had that one video
that
we put
up. I think our crowd would love to see you doing
a
disco dance. Yeah, but that wasn't disco dancing. Oh, well, it was kind of disco dancing.
It kind of was,
yeah.
It kind of was. But, you know, that's...
Thank you. Rachel said my bangs look even. They're a little rough, I got to tell you. But I had to put the scissors down.
Rachel, just right now,
thank
since
you,
you're commenting, why did you not send a picture in? Do you have any decent excuse? You were supposed to send a picture in of your childhood. I personally requested it.
Right.
You're up for a dubious award here. You could win Line of the Day, which you've never been close to.
I know, and Pam never came on. I really wanted to give her that award for counting how many times you were touching your face.
Anybody have a count for
he
tonight?
He touches everything.
I would, if somebody would count.
When we go out, he's always touching things. I know I keep saying that, but it is our
brutal.
Pet peeve.
I don't understand it. I really like me, apparently.
I don't know what it is.
I don't know what that's about.
I know. Well, you've seen how much he touches his hair. No skater. Sorry, Chris.
Josh and I laughed a lot. See, but that's Josh. He's killed most of his brain cells. You know, I mean, the boy's not there.
We love her brother,
yeah. Yeah, just, you know, we got to pray for Josh. There's something wrong with him.
No, we love him.
So our question for tomorrow, right? What cartoon do you still enjoy? And what was your childhood go-to cartoon?
Right.
So mine would have been, back in the day, would have been Johnny Quest. I'll probably put something about that tomorrow.
Johnny Quest was your one?
Debbie got, we kind of got reintroduced to it. I liked it as a kid, but remember, I didn't have TV.
Oh, that's right.
I was a Christian.
He was deprived.
I was a Christian. We didn't have television.
Right. Right, he didn't get to watch TV.
My mom wouldn't let us go to movies. You know why? Because she called them a cinema. Cinema.
No, we weren't really allowed.
We don't know what the ema was, but the sin, she says they're in there sinning. I don't know what people were doing. But when Steve and I would drive by theaters, we'd be like, what are you evil are they doing in there? People doing all
See, then it does make you a little bit more curious, doesn't it?
And then
it?
My mother would say lascivious behavior, and I was like, what's lascivious?
But you like the word.
We used to use it as a swear word when Mom wasn't looking. What the lascivious are you doing?
What was the word? You used a word the other day, and he's like...
A swear word?
Yeah, it
like
wasn't...
A Christian swear word?
No, it was a Christian,
what,
Christian
the Sheol?
Swear word. You know,
Sheol?
Like, Sheol.
Yeah, that was one we could use. We made that one up. And we couldn't use pee or poo. Sorry if I offended you right now. But we made up skeet. That was number one.
You couldn't say that to your parents?
No, we said skeet. I came up with that one. And number two was a duke.
There
you
go.
We had skeets and dukes. That's it. There you go, Chris. We're back to potty humor.
Right. See? You know what? He did. He has skipped it a couple times, Chris.
Yeah, just for you, Chris, because I know it offends you. That's the last thing I want to do is offend Chris Soderlund, who's got
ninja
skills.
Face cutting touches 1.2 million. I wouldn't be surprised. He touches his face a lot. He does touch his face a lot.
Heckle and Jekyll was Dale Metter's, his favorite cartoon. Face touching.
Bandit comment. The dog.
Scooby Doo for Pandora.
Tell you.
Alex Conway, what was your favorite cartoon growing up? Pandora says Scooby Doo. Yeah, that was a good one. But
that was
past me. So
some of them scared me.
We got the Three Stooges, and we didn't have TV, so we got little 8mm movies because my parents had a movie projector and a movie projector.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Right.
So we had that, but Mom took them away from us after Steve and I were poking each other in the eye.
Yeah.
We didn't realize they never really poke each other in the eye. They poke each other in the forehead.
I don't think anybody's surprised about that.
Yeah. So we got in trouble. I think it was me poking Steve because she realized Steve still had potential, but I was sort of toast by that age. So.
When Chuck Norris does division, there is no remainder.
Oh,
that's
nice.
That's Pandora. That's a math joke.
Okay, I don't know. That. See if you know this cartoon. Linda Putz said this cartoon, Bandit the Dog.
I know. I saw that on there. I don't remember that one.
I don't know that one, Linda. You got to send me a picture of that or something. I remember Johnny Quest. Linda Putz says that one, yep.
Tom
Chris liked Fred Flintstone.
Fred Flintstone.
Love Fred Flintstone.
Right. Yabba dabba doo.
Yeah.
I don't know what. I love Bugs Bunny. Like, I loved that growing up. Bugs
Bunny.
I didn't like Roadrunner. Like, the whole thing where they're Coyote and, you know, Wile E. Coyote, and he's chasing him all the time, and Wile E. gets hurt. I always felt sorry for Wile E. Coyote. Yeah.
That's where the word Acme came for everything.
Yeah, Acme.
Because Acme. Yeah. Everything you ordered came from the Acme store. Jim's birthday dance was like the Bob Fosse dancing. See? Patty just said that. Thank you, Patty. She appreciates my moves.
Yeah. Some serious moves he's got there.
Bandit was with Johnny. Oh, Bandit. Okay. Yeah, that's right. Bandit was the dog on Johnny Quest.
You didn't remember that?
No, I forgot that. All right. Who else has got a dog or a dog? Who got a
Linda
cartoon?
Linda liked the Jetsons. Actually, Sydney still likes the Jetsons.
Yeah.
She likes that one.
She and I were watching those here a while ago.
We were able to get them on one of the... So what's another one?
Yeah. Got another one? Give us one. We're waiting on you people.
I thought you were reading.
Oh, no.
No.
Oh, well, Virginia Mahoney finally joined.
Oh, hi, Virginia.
An hour and a half late, Virginia.
Well, and she didn't give us a picture. I bet she would have had a really cute picture.
Let me take a look at her. Where is she? That's right.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Ronnie Smith just joined. Ronnie, good to have you here. So,
all right. Do you have a serious word for us today, or was that?
Well,
what you
we were said talking
earlier?
A little bit about it, and I just felt today that really something good is about to happen. So I got my announcement, my report from the doctor today about the kidney stone, which I know we've mentioned several
we're
times.
We're going to call it the boulder.
Yeah, the boulder. It's 11mm, which our Canadians have translated as 4.5 inches. Point four. I don't know the decimal right. points. We don't know what those are for.
He
those
struggles.
Are from Canada. But we were talking about this, so. I got the news, and I was just kind of sitting there. And you know how you first get any kind of bad news? You just start kind of going down the rabbit hole. And I was going down the rabbit hole, and she was really trying to pull me out of it and suck me out of it, quite frankly.
Suck
she's
him
like,
out of it.
Yeah, she's like,
he went
come
down.
On, we got a lot of good stuff. So she went for a walk. I sat there at my desk, kind of was trying to find a doctor is what I was doing. And my phone rang randomly, and it was David R. Wells from Canada.
The Reverend David Wells.
Yeah. Now, David and I don't talk a lot. Susan and I talk more with all of us, Messenger and stuff like that. Dave's up here. He's like a 33rd level Illuminati compared to us. Just dumb little. We're not even Jedis.
Yeah.
We're just Padawans. So Dave calls and he spends like 2 or 3 minutes. He didn't know what was going on. He spends 2 or 3 minutes telling me about this buddy of his he wants to connect me with and how much the guy is like me. But he had paid me a bunch of compliments. And it was just,
kind of needed it.
Yeah, you do.
Right,
and he just
right.
really needed it. He didn't fluff my ego. He just kind of reminded me of what I'd been.
Right.
And a couple of the statements that he made that really touched me, which I thought applied to most of us tonight, is very simply, he said, Jim has always been good at finding a niche in ministry.
Right.
And reinventing himself. And that I just really needed to hear that. You know, I'm not worried about dying. I mean, when you've lost a spouse, you can handle anything after that.
Right.
And especially somebody as close as Debbie and I. I don't want to die because the relationship we have, I want to be on the planet, but I'm not afraid of it anymore. So when we heard that, we thought, it's a doable thing. There might be some difficulty going through it, but we can handle this. And I realized we are built for where we are right now.
Right.
You're here because you're built for this.
Right.
You can handle this.
Right.
This COVID crap, you can handle this. Yes, it's difficult, but we have to remember to keep your eye on the prize or whatever little quote you want to use. But for me, David just reminding me, here's your past.
Well, you know, after my divorce and everything, and I would go with Debbie and him over to Walter Reed, when I would see people that, I mean, they're literally missing three limbs. And they were, I mean, some actually, I mean, they're called sled boys, where they lost, really, they don't even have anything from the hip down. And you realize, oh my word, like, we are so grateful. And almost through any circumstance, not all, I know it's hard,
yeah.
but we can be grateful.
Yeah.
There's something to be grateful for.
There's something, and so when she came back off her walk, we had another little chat, and I told her about Dave's call and how much it meant to me and all that
right.
kind of stuff. And so we embraced the day.
Right.
And it's like Justin, the single amputee, 101st Airborne, blew off a leg. Over in Afghanistan, called me after Debbie died, and he said, Jim, I remember the day
right.
I embraced the road ahead, realizing it's not going to grow back.
Embrace the road ahead.
Yep, and I know, it's a kidney stone, and it's not fun and all that cool stuff. I've had one before, but man, that was 25 years ago.
A kidney boulder.
Yeah, that's it. Linda has sent us another Chuck. Chuck Norris is... I missed it here.
Chuck lights up when you plug him in.
When you plug him in, that's perfect. Pandora, you're like totally into this Chuck thing. I'm really proud of you. Pandora says Chuck Norris can start a fire with an ice cube.
That's awesome.
That might be Pandora.
I know. I think Pandora should get it. Well, you got our first one, I think.
She's got two of them. She would actually get the lifetime achievement. She wouldn't get this one. She would get this one is what she would get. Right. She could emotionally possess this one. But we have some contestants for the line of the day.
Yes, we do.
So we do. So James, with his Chuck Norris quote about something about, Chuck Norris is the Force in Star Wars.
Right.
That was his.
That was good.
And then Chris Soderlund entered in with the street name. Oh, yeah, Chuck Norris, because you can't cross him.
Oh, you can't cross him.
Yeah, that's right. And then Rachel comes in with... Chuck counted to infinity twice, but we know she stole that. We're pretty sure she Googled it, so we may have to disqualify her. But she came back in with a strong second line, which
yes.
was David Wells is Chuck Norris.
David Wells is Chuck Norris.
I'm going with Rachel. Because David rung my bell today, too. He called me up and kind of built me up. You know how you got to do that? And you
right.
know what? Maybe that's a reminder for all of us. We call it pinging.
Right.
And you got pinged by a friend the other
pinged.
Day.
Yeah, I
and
love that.
And maybe this is a good thing for us to do. Tonight, with the rest of your night, find a few people you think might be down. And even if they're not, who cares? Give them a ping.
Right.
And just say you're checking in.
Yeah. Check in. Or like, there's a respiratory therapist that she's like, her name is Angel. It so fits her. And she's amazing. And she's really been on my mind because she's a respiratory therapist. So I've been praying for her. But...
Oh, Linda.
Yeah, so I pinged her.
Linda,
she
glad.
She pinged me back.
Linda joined here just a few minutes ago, but Linda seriously says, Jim, I had my third kidney stone removed. You can do this, yeah.
Aww.
Yeah, we're going
did
for
removal. Did they count it out of you?
Yeah, you may have to contact me on message
yeah.
after this is done. Linda, we'll talk about it.
He's struggling.
Give me so Rachel thinks she deserves the award. Rachel, would you like to log in on why you believe, compared to the other contestants, even though they are valid, your line was the strongest of the day. Will you want to give us a little stern? Susan is giving you some fuel for your fire. She says Dave is going to cry because it's just too much.
Chuck Norris knows Victoria's Secret. Okay, that's pretty good. Pandora, those are pretty good. I don't know where you found that
Pandora,
one.
Pandora, are you
funny.
Cheating? I think Pandora might be cheating. Can you really be this creative,
that
Pandora?
That is really good.
I have no idea what is happening.
That's awesome.
Put your cursor there
sorry,
for a
baby.
Second. Oh, you're fine.
All right. There we go.
There you are.
All right,
so
well,
we're
going to yeah.
award the dubious award of distinction that Rachel Doring is being able to get this because she gave us the line, David Wells is Chuck Norris. Now, when you say a line that powerful, people, in comedy, you give a pause. Okay, so we're going to give a pause, and we'll do it again. We'll practice. David Wells is Chuck Norris.
Right.
Two, three, four. There you go. All right, you give it a grand pause like that. And so, Rachel, we would like you to receive the award. Just reach out to your computer right now or to your phone. There you go. Accept
there
the award.
We go.
You get to emotionally possess that award until Friday. Friday's a big show. Got a lot going on Friday. So you want to come back for that. If you would, do us a couple of favors. If you would share this podcast, we would be super grateful. If you would do that, help us kind of spread the fun, spread the joy.
You didn't pray.
Huh?
You didn't pray.
I know, we're not there yet.
Oh, I thought you were just going to sign off or something.
We want you to share that. And also, if you would take a listen to our podcast. We're trying to put podcasts in this format. We've been doing them for about a year. Do one a week at least. And so if you'll check those out. We'd be grateful.
They're really short.
Yeah.
They're not really podcasts. They're just like these little snippets. They could be commercials.
We call them a snicker and a sticker. You want to play the commercial?
They're so fitting for Jim. Actually, I don't have it ready.
Oh, okay. So we're going to play, we got a brand new commercial for it, but we're just pushing that. You can Google Jim Peters or Accidental Magic is the name of it, which is what we're hoping this program does for you.
Right.
Accidental Magic.
Put a smile on your face.
So we're going to pray for those people that are in pain. Since I'm in pain, we're going to pray for people in pain.
Virginia said she had a tough day, or a tough couple of days.
Oh, did she?
Yeah,
so, Virginia, we're going to pray for you. We'll adopt you tonight. And
for your boulder, Dad said I should turn you upside down. Oh. Knock that thing. I should knock it out of him, shouldn't I, Dad?
Yeah.
We know how to do this.
Yeah, that's true. So we're going to pray for the people that are in pain. If you're in pain tonight, whether it be emotional or maybe just in mental or spiritual, or you want to put somebody in pain, I can completely relate to that. So let's just pray for that. All right, so Jesus, we are super grateful that you have brought us together as family and as team, Lord. Thanks that we can have some fun on this Facebook Live, Lord. We ask that you would go through the airwaves here and you would touch those that are in pain. I thank you, Lord, that you're my healer, you're my deliverer. You're the Alpha and the Omega. You know our days from the beginning to the end. You know when is our last day. And we thank you, Jesus, that we are going through this virus knowing you are with us, Lord. And so we pray all the way to Australia, Virginia. She's there and had a couple of rough days. We pray that you would be her healer, her deliverer, Lord, and her encourager. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thanks
for joining us, guys. It really was
now
fun
enjoy.
Tonight.
I'm going to play our video one more
time. Oh, that's right. Friday at 7, we'll be here.
All right. Love you guys.
Here we go.
I could get you satisfied, son.
Yeah,
and you know we out here every day with it. I'm going to show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to.